13 of NFL predictions here for Lit Sports Online, and Gerald, you somehow edged ahead of me in the prediction count here.
Yep. Told you. Never out. Never out.
So, looks like you're 82 and 64. I'm 81 and 65. And Ross, who's not with us tonight,
25 and 19 with a winning record. Yep, well, he came through last week.
Well, you and him both had a really good week last week. I did pretty good too, but not quite as good.
Still stupid for picking the Reds again.
Yeah, but at least I picked the Chiefs, right? So I got something that you two didn't get. But Ross will actually be texting in his picks for this week, so we will still be able to keep you up to date on what he's thinking.
Let's get down to it. First up, we have the Chiefs taking on the Atlanta Falcons in Atlanta this weekend. I'm going to give the win to the Falcons. I think they've been looking good and consistent lately, and they're at home inside the dome. They're going to get a victory.
Yeah, I like the Chiefs a lot, but I am also going to take the Falcons in this one. I just don't see them doing enough to limit Matt Ryan's passing yards in this one. He should be able to get enough done through the air to beat the Chiefs at home.
And Ross?
Ross is picking the Atlanta Falcons as well.
Smart man. Next up, we have the Detroit Lions traveling to New Orleans to take on the Saints. I think the Lions are going to get an upset here this weekend. I don't want the Lions.
Well, that's a bold prediction. The Saints are coming off of a big win at home against the Rams.
What better time for them to lose then?
Well, the thing is that, Gerald, they're at home again. And the Lions, well, sure, they're a nice mediocre team, but they're not going to be able to do enough here for me, and I'm going to go with the Saints. Okay. And Ross is taking the Saints as well.
Okay. Next up, we have the Rams taking on the New England Patriots in New England. There ain't no way in the world that the Rams are going to pull this off. Patriots all the way.
You know, as much as I want the Rams to, you know, just tear up Tom Brady this week, it's just the Patriots are such a tough team to beat, and at home even tougher. Coming off a bad loss against the Saints where we didn't play any defense, I'm unfortunately going to take the Patriots on this one as well.
Against your own team. It happens.
And Ross, I mean, do I even need to check the text? He's taking the Patriots here as well.
Hey. There's no question. Next up, we have the Broncos traveling to Jacksonville to take on the Jaguars. Again, another game I don't see the Broncos losing.
Yeah, the Broncos, they lost last week against the Chiefs at home, but it was close. Jaguars have just been such a horrible team this year. They have, like, two wins.
They're consistently horrible, let's be honest here.
Well, see, the thing is, that, like, their team didn't change that much personnel-wise from last year to this year, and yet this year they're doing so much worse. Like, it's kind of hard to understand,
yeah,
but
I think y'all grow together.
But, yeah, I mean, maybe Blake Bortles last year was an aberration, and he's just showing his true colors this year. I don't know what's going on with them, but I'm going to also take the Broncos here.
All right.
And Ross is taking Broncos.
Of course. Next up, we have the Houston Texans traveling to Green Bay to take on the Packers. And I think the Packers are, I think it's right for a win for them. They're home, Lambeau Field, it's cold December. Yeah, I think the Packers are going to win.
Well, they also won last week against the Eagles, which none of us predicted.
That's true.
To pull that one out, and now they get one at home, going up against the Texans. Texans don't have a whole lot going for them, really. I mean, Lamar Miller's proved to be an inefficient running back. We all thought he'd be great as a workhorse for them. Hasn't really panned out that well. Don't have a good quarterback either. Really, the only thing the Texans have going for them is their defense, but I don't think it's enough. I'm going to give this one to the Packers.
All right.
And Ross, also taking Packers.
Fair enough. Next up, two teams which are close to the bottom of the barrel in their respective divisions. The Eagles travel to Cincinnati to take on the Bengals. The Bengals, fool me once, they're going to get fooled again when they lose to the Eagles.
See, the thing about this one is I actually would take the Bengals if AJ Green was healthy. He's still doubtful to play. So for that reason, I'm going to say the Eagles bounce back and actually win this one.
Next up, we have...
And by the way, Ross, going with the Eagles.
Of course. Next up, we have the Dolphins in their rushing attack taking on the Baltimore Ravens after an impressive victory and their stout defense in Baltimore. I think the Ravens are going to pull off a pretty big victory here. It's going to shock the world.
I agree. I don't think it's going to be something that shocks the world. I think most people are probably thinking they'd win. Ravens are really good at the stop and the run. That's one thing they've consistently been good at, even, you
know. And I think that's true. They can stop, you know, I think that's Miami's the only thing they have right now is a run. And I think as long as they stop the run, they'll...
Yeah, I mean, lately Tannehill's been doing a little bit better, but he's just so inconsistent.
Yeah.
And, you know, I just don't see him being able to run the ball here. And coming into M&T Bank Stadium, tough place to play. There's nothing really to like about the Dolphins for me, so I'm also going to pick the Ravens.
And I'm not even going to let you pick the phone. We know Ross is picking the Ravens.
Yeah. We know
the Ravens. Just to check. Check to make sure, though. You got to check to make sure.
Yep, Ravens.
I see you told you. No Ross. Next up, we have the San Francisco 49ers traveling to Chicago to take on the Bears. I think the 49ers might pick up a victory.
Yeah, they have the worst record, but only by a factor of one. And Colin Kaepernick, you know, the way he's been playing, I think they've been unlucky to lose some of these recent games. I think this is going to be the week where he finally, you know, is able to capitalize on his good performances, and it's enough to cross him over that finish line and beat the Bears with an away game. So I'm going to go with the 49ers.
All right.
Ross also going 49ers this week.
Good stuff. Next up, we have the Buffalo Bills traveling to Oakland to take on the Raiders. And I think Oakland's just going to keep on rolling.
I think the Bills can make this one an interesting game, but I don't see enough there to want to take them. Raiders with the home field advantage, they're a hot team. I'm not going to call upset on this one. I'm going to go with the Raiders also.
Perfect.
And Ross is also going Raiders.
Predicted that one. He tends to pick smart. Next up, we have the New York Giants traveling to Pittsburgh to take on the Steelers. This is going to be an interesting game, and I think this is a game that could go either way. For the sake of being a Ravens fan, my bias pulls me to want the Giants to win. Logic kind of says maybe otherwise, because you don't want to count out the Steelers in Pittsburgh. I think I'm going to go with Steeler. I think being in Pittsburgh is literally going to be the X factor.
I'll go bold prediction here and say Giants.
Okay.
I think there's enough here that it's going to be a close game. You think maybe Giants can go ahead and get across the finish line. Sure, I mean, Steelers, they got Roethlisberger, they got Bell, they got Brown. But, I mean, I don't know. I just got a feeling about the Giants this week.
I have that same feeling, but... Logic, being in Pittsburgh, I just can't pick against the Steelers this weekend.
All right, let's see what Ross has to say about it. He's going to go with the home favorite, the Steelers.
All right, next up. Kurt, I'm playing for a contract. Cousins is taking his Redskins into traveling to Arizona to hopefully pick up a victory against the Cardinals. And I think they'll do just that. Kurt Cousins has been looking great this year, and I obviously, playing for a contract gets in your head. Yeah, I think they're going to pull off another victory here.
Well, I'm actually going to go with the home team on this one, the Cardinals. You know, they have pretty good defense. They have enough weapons on offense, even with the running game. Mm-hmm. David Johnson's been great. In fact, great is probably an understatement for the kind of productions he's put up. I feel like the Redskins are just going to fall short a little bit, just like they did last week against the Cowboys. So I see him disappointing. Let's see what Ross has to say about the Redskins. And he's going to actually go with them. He's going with the way win for the Redskins.
All right. Next up, we got the Tampa Bay Buccaneers heading to San Diego to take on the Chargers. And this could be a very close game with two teams I don't really care too much about. But I think I'm going to go with the home favorite, the Chargers.
Yeah, this is a really hard one for me to pick. I feel like these teams are comparable in a lot of ways. Buccaneers do have the X factor of having, I think, a better receiver in Mike Evans. But I don't know. You got the home field advantage. Buccaneers are deploying Doug Martin. Don't know how well he's going to do. You know what? I'll go with the Chargers here as well.
All right, who's Ross got?
And Ross is going with the Buccaneers away team on this one.
Wow. Split decision. Next up, we got Carolina Panthers taking on the Seattle Seahawks. I think this could be a pretty interesting game, but I think definitely, obviously, they're in Seattle. Seahawks, you know, for a lot of that victory. There's no beating that one.
Upset alert! Upset alert! I'm taking the Carolina Panthers in Seattle to win this game. Now, you might ask yourself, Justin, you're crazy. Why are you doing this? Well, let's look at it this way. The Seahawks foolishly got rid of Christian Michael, and he's now on the Packers. They have an injured CJ Procise. The only guy they got in that backfield, Thomas Rawls, who, frankly, is not as good as he was last year. I think he had a hot streak last year. Now he's not a good running back. He's going to be ineffective. I don't see him getting even 70 yards rushing in this game. And I think that lack of a running game, combined with the fact that the Panthers are no slouches, the Panthers are getting the upset here and are going to win.
You literally just won ham on the universe. Wow.
What do you got to say about that? Bold prediction, huh? Upset
They're
alert?
Taking on the Panthers. Cam Newton doesn't even know if he's a quarterback right now. He has no idea who he is. Man's an identity crisis. There's no way the Panthers are traveling to Seattle. Seattle!
You know how many points Seattle put up last week? Five. They put up 5 points last week, okay?
Dude, they played the Eagles. Russell Wilson got a receiving touchdown. What?
And last week, 5 points. So, Seattle offense in a flux.
They're playing Carolina. They're playing Carolina. Carolina's a fraction of the team they were last year.
It's all
a fraction.
But you got to ask yourself, is Russell Wilson going to be able to throw the ball well
enough? Cam Newton going to be awake for this game? You can't win without a quarterback. Cam Newton has been abysmal this year.
All right.
Man's in an identity crisis.
It's like that
As my sister says, big for nothing.
It's like that one week where you picked the Browns for an upset alert, but this time... I'll actually be getting to laugh in your face.
I'm going to be getting to laugh in your face. You know what? We need to get together and watch this game. Done.
All right, what's Ross got to say about it? Of course, he's going with the Seahawks.
Because he's smart. What? I get your points. No backfield. But the Panthers and Seattle.
Hey, what happens if Rawls gets hurt? Do they have a running back to deploy after that? I mean, they're in some dire straits in that running game. Hey, gotta call it.
Alright.
I call it like I see it.
Hey, alright, man. Alright. Last but not least, Monday Night Football. Wow, really? Monday Night Football. The Colts traveling to New York to take on the Jets. I think the Colts are going to pull off a pretty good victory here. They're going to get one.
You know, I would say upset alert here, but is it really even an upset?
No,
neither team has a great record.
No.
I'm going to go with the home team, the Jets. They put Fitzpatrick back at quarterback. I think there's enough there to get it done. Andrew Luck coming back this week, do you know?
That's the X factor right there. There you go.
So, yeah, I mean, who knows if he's going to be dinged up.
If he plays, no doubt about it, a victory.
I'm going to roll with the Jets regardless, right, and we'll see what happens. What does Ross have to say about the Monday night game? And he's going to go with the Colts.
All right. The Panthers, really?
Yep, really.
Oh my gosh, that.
I called them an upset before and they won.
If
okay.
the Panthers win this, you know, their season's validated. They can just
any given Sunday,
right?
Wow. So that concludes our episode of Week 13 predictions. It's Justin, Gerald, and calling from the phone this time, Ross.
Don't forget to like and subscribe our videos and share it. And leave us a little comment below and let us know what you think. Take care.